Good afternoon, students. Once again, I am here to deliver the lecture on the point precise writing. It is from the unit 4, which is already we are discussing some point discussed in previous lectures. So, precise writing, precise is its meaning is the summarize. So, precise writing in means that you are summarizing the points. Summarizing the points. For that, what you have to do one thing. We have to do the exercise on a compression. Compression in the sense, if suppose you are having the one of the that passage topic, then from that topic you have to collect the information. Understand that particular topic and then summarize about that particular topic. This is nothing but the process of precise writing. Getting my point, what I want to say, share here. And why we are doing this thing? Because many people, what they are doing? They are not reading that particular topic that in that way, or you can say that much seriously. You can say that much seriously. So, while doing this particular precise writing task, what we are going to do, what you are going to do is that you are reading that particular entire topic and you are thinking that particular topic, it is having main important these points. Or you can say that you are understanding the subject of that topic and you are converting that particular topic in a small paragraph or in a very small summarize kind of a task. And at that time, then the reader will pay attention what exactly this particular thing is there. He will get clear idea about that particular thing. That is the main thing of this particular precise writing. Right? Normally what we are doing? We are reading that particular things and we are not giving that much attention on that particular thing. That may be, whatever may be that there, we are not giving that much attention. But if suppose we are summarizing, if suppose we are getting that particular summary of that topic, then we are taking, we are maintaining our mind so that it will give the attention on that particular topics. That is the thing of this particular precise writing. That's why this particular precise writing, it is, you can say that sometimes it is important one. And then what the exact use of this particular precise writing is there? How it will be helping you here? Now, suppose you are considering the precise writing, then your mind or you are giving that much attention on that particular points. What you are reading on that thing, you are giving that much attention. You are understanding that particular summary points. Normally, no one do this particular thing for the entire topic. But if suppose you are considering that some, then your attention you are giving on that particular. You are maintaining your that particular concentration on that particular thing. That is the one use of this particular summarizing. And which gives the clearly idea about that particular topic. Because you are writing that in that way. Right? That is the main thing. Another thing is that as per the its exercise, you will get the, or it can say that it is give the attention, or it will give the it will teach you how to express one's thoughts clearly on that particular point. That is the thing. That means whenever you are doing the exercise on that topic, then it will give you how to teach, or it will teach you how to express the thing. Express the thing in your thoughts. That is the main thing. That is the, you can see that use of that particular thing. Okay. And third one is that precise writing, it is a great value for practical life. It is a great value because in business peoples, you can see that stenographers or that particular lawyers or that you can see that businessmen, okay, they are using such a things. They are not considering entire topic. They are giving him a small hints, small points. That is nothing but your summary of that particular point. That is the use of this particular precise writing. Right? Got the thing? What exactly I want to share about the precise writing. Right? Now, then how this particular precise writing can be done? Or you can say that what is the exactly method of this particular procedure to write that particular thing. In this, first point is the main important point is the reading. Reading. See, while writing that particular, summarize that particular point, right, in the form of a precise writing, then reading it is important. But the process for which you are doing that particular topic, that particular subject, you have to read it carefully. For which purpose? What exactly subject is there? Right, this is the one thing. What it is saying about the subject, that means how it is clearly mentioned that particular topic regarding that subject, you have to get that particular idea. That for that purpose you have to read one. And usually you are required to share the title, and for that thing you have to understand that particular topic. For that purpose, you have to read it carefully. Third one is that if suppose you want to give the in detail about the passage as well as its main purpose, then it is very important to you that you have to read it further. For that thing, you have to read it further. Necessarily, you have to repeat that reading of that particular thing. And another point of view for the particular reading is that you should now be a position to decide what the parts of this particular passage are essential and what the parts are cumulatively unimportant for that particular summarizing the points. For that thing, it is very For that reason, you have to read the topic carefully, right? So that you will get the idea about the what exactly that particular passage is there. And by using that passage, you can summarize the thing. Once you are completed the reading carefully for that particular passage, by understanding the kind of that particular subject, and what the subject exactly want to say, right? If you are finished one, then next procedure you have to do is the rough writing. Next is the you have to do is the rough writing, or you can say that writing of that particular passage in the form of a rough work, in the form of the rough work or draft. Right, that means you have to follow the second procedure as the writing in the rough format. So for that thing, whatever you are gone through that particular passage, you have to detect some sort of the points related to that particular subject, related to that particular subject, and it should be in proper order. It should be in a proper order. Right, and you can use your few words, your own words for the writing it one, but it is again considering that particular topic. Right, this is the thing. Now, next is the from that particular writing concept is the another point is the important points. You have to consider that particular main important points for that particular writing. That summary, and from that first one is the precise should be all in your own words. Whatever you are summarizing, you have to consider it in your own words. Right, that is the thing. There should not be any patchwork. Right. Second thing is the precise must be a connected whole. That means what? It should be with consideration of that particular passage, that subject, that topic. Even though you are using your own words, it should not be outside from that particular passage. It is important. The precise must be completed and self-contained one. There should not be any miss, any point. It should be completed one. And self-contained, that means that particular thing. It is only the gist. Main purport or general meaning of the passage which you have to express. That means fourth thing you are going to express is it should be considered in a main passage. Related to that, you have to express one. And important thing is that whatever you are writing, the precise, it is in a simple form, in a simple language, considering the direct grammatical English concept. There should not be any, you can say that, a heavy and in a different word format. It should be proper grammatical order, without having any mistakes. Clarification. Getting my point? So this thing you have to consider while in the writing of that particular precise. Now next one is the under this particular procedure. Next thing is the, you can say that writing procedure is the, next thing is the art of compression. Art of compression. Right, it is also important part. See, in this particular compression concept, you are not bonded to original order. Whatever the fact, it is considered in a passage. But whenever you are expressing the meaning, it should be clearly mentioned one in that particular whatever you are transcribing in the form of that particular part in the summarize. It should be in a clearly having the meaning. There should not be any you can say that confusion. There should not be any confusion. Right. Fourth point it is for this particular writing procedure is the indirect speech. That means you have to follow the rules for writing the precise which is considered in a direct speech. That means verb or after a verb of saying in the past tense, or you have to use the all the, you can see that rules for that particular tense or verb or adjective. Whenever you are using, you know, necessarily you have to consider the commas, correct sequence of that particular tense, past tense or whatever the things, correct order should be there. Okay, that you have to follow in that particular writing the you can see that precise, right? This is the thing. Okay, now after writing this particular precise, next step is the revision. Okay, revision in the sense, once you are ready with this particular summary by considering these procedure concepts, having the some different points, then you have to read it carefully before finalizing this particular summarize, or you can say that summary before finalizing this particular summary. That means we are saying, no, whenever we are making any you can say that document, at that time roughly we are mentioning point, and then we are going through that particular points, and then we are finalizing the that particular copy. Final copy we are preparing. Like that you have to do here also. Once you are considering the, that particular reading, writing, and from that writing concept, whatever the procedure it is there, after that, if you have to go through the entire whatever the summarized points. And then, here you have to take care about any main important point, it is whether it is missed one, or an important point whether it is considered in this summary. That thing you have to take care about this particular thing. And for that, this revision point it is important. This revision point it is important. So, by considering this thing, you have to write the, you can see that, this particular precise. Okay, you have to do the writing of this particular precise for any passage or any topic. Getting my point? So, whatever the thing I just shared, it is again summarized in the notes. I am not discussing that point because same will be repeated the thing. So, remember that precise writing, it is nothing but you are summarizing the passage. You are doing the that particular summary of that particular topic. Passage by understanding the subject, by understanding the concept of the subject, and by going through the detailed, you can see that main important points of that particular passage, you are making the summary of that passage. That is the thing about this particular, you can see that, precise writing. Okay? Okay, next we will discuss the next point. So, I will continue with the next point. Thank you. Okay. Once again, good afternoon, students. With continuation of this, the precise writing topic, I am considering the next topic as from this particular unit 4 is the comprehension. What exactly comprehension is there? What is the meaning of this particular comprehension? Comprehension exercise, it is consist of a passage and upon which some questions are asked to the students, right? And here the student's ability it is checked one by asking the different question on that particular passage. Means what? Here the passage, one small passage it is given one. The students, they have to read that passage once or two times or three times. They have to understand that particular passage, right? They have to understand that particular passage, and in this particular comprehension, what that particular writer he is doing, he is giving the question bank. That means for some for few questions he will consider for the, on that particular passage, and students have to write that particular right answer for that every questions. And for that purpose, students have to carefully read this particular passage. This is nothing but our comprehension. Okay, so while doing this particular thing, what you have to take the care? The student should have to take the care as, that means some hints are given for this particular comprehension as, read the passage fairly to, and quickly to get the general idea. That means you have to read the passage carefully, right? This is the one thing. Read again, little slowly so as to know the details. Once you are previous in hint what they are given, you have to fairly, quickly you have to read one. Once you are completed that reading one or two times, then next again you have to read it one and little slowly. To know the details about this particular passage. Third one, study the question thoroughly. Which kind of a questions they are asked one? Just go through that particular questions. Understand the questions. Understand the questions. And then you have to write your own, in your own words and neatly, precisely. Rewrite that particular thing. This is the thing. Use complete sentence. Don't miss any sentence. Complete sentence. In complete sentence, you have to write the answer. If suppose in question, if they are asked to give the meaning of any word, then you have to express the idea in clearly. That means for that your concentration should be there to read while reading the that particular passage. Because in questions, if suppose they are asking any words meaning, that at that time it is important, because you don't have to exactly write the words meaning. You have to consider that particular meaning with consideration of that passage, with consideration of that particular passage, not only the considering the that particular words meaning. So like that it is considered one. So if you are understand this particular thing, then it will be, might be in your that particular 5th to 10th class, you gone through this particular, you read the following passage and give the answers properly, or write the answers in for that given passage. Like that it was there in exams. So like this it is there, only you have to take care while reading the that particular passage in a carefully. You have to read one and understand that particular ideas about that particular passage, and understand the meaning of that particular words which are considered in the passage. It is important one. But if you are going through this particular thing, then it will be help you how to explain this particular thing. So in notes, just I given one that specimen, and see like this particular passage is there. One example, right? It is up to this point. It is there, which is written in a blue pen. And in this particular, I am consider the red pen for writing the question. So questions are asked on that above topic, and for that questions, I just summarize the answer. How to you can see that write that particular question. You get the idea. For that purpose, I consider this. Okay, so. Students, I will share this, as usual I said that I will share this particular, you can say that notes to you people, so that you will get the idea. So today we discuss the main two things. One is the precise writing, and second one is the comprehension, how the comprehension it is there and how the precise writing it is considered one. So unit 4, it is having the you can say that objective. Already I am discussing every time, its main objective is to develop the communication skills, right? It is the main objective of this particular, you can see that, unit 4. Okay, thank you guys. If you are having any doubts, you can ask me anytime. And through this video, I want to share that your mid exam, it will be start from 20th April to 5th or 26th April, up to there. You will get the exact schedule, and it is on the online basis, and you will be asked MCQs questions in the mid exam. So be ready with this particular thing. And this already you know that mid exam it is considering from unit 1, 2, 3. Okay, and you have to ready with that particular thing. Okay, from my side I already shared the that particular all the whatever the data it is required for unit 1, 2, 3 with you people. If anybody, he wants, once again, he can mail me or he can ask me, I will share it one. Okay. Thank you, and study well. Okay.